Jetpack Aviation has been developing vertical takeoff and landing, or VTOL, vehicles for over 10 years. You may know it for its jetpacks, which put it on the map way back when. But did you know that it has branched out from the personal luxury toys? Jetpack Aviation has established Maiman Aerospace to handle the design and development of VTOLs meant for something a bit greater than a fun time. One of the ways that Maiman Aerospace will tackle those means of greatness is through the Speeder AUV, which we will be covering in today's video. So what is the Speeder AUV? Well, first off, the AUV stands for Air Utility Vehicle, and that is what this slick prototype is all about. Those glossy angles, night black colors, and all-around video game-like design are more than just show. They also cut through wind resistance like no other. The Speeder AUV is designed to be around the size of a motorbike and uses 8 jet engines as a means of propulsion. Those jet engines run off of sustainable aviation fuel. Safety is a significant concern for the team, as you can imagine, and that's why they've installed a proprietary onboard system that helps rebalance the engines in the event of trouble. To help users take control of the wheel, they also made the flying bike as easy to use as they could manage. Ease of use is a major part of the design for the Speeder AUV, because the company plans on getting these in the hands of police, firefighters, and other emergency operations. The faster and easier they can be trained in using these machines, the better. Another use is for cargo, as it comes with a cargo mode. While in this mode, it can fly for 400 miles at 500 miles per hour and carry loads of up to 1,000 pounds. It's also designed to be modular, shifting from a manned flyer to automated flight to remotely piloted and back. The Speeder AUV is not available for purchase right now, but further flight tests are scheduled for later this year, and piloted tests are slated for the end of the year. It's an exciting time to be alive, with not only a swath of eVTOLs being developed like straight from our favorite sci-fi films and novels, but affordable eVTOLs as well. That's what the eggheads over at Ziva hope to do, at least, with their new saucer-styled setup called Zero. Rising populations, as they say, are reducing our surface availability bit by bit, and the fabled eVTOL may be the remedy, or at least the symptoms. The pilot is meant to board this personal vessel horizontally, with their chest touching the floor. A glass display allows you to see both ahead and below. Speaking of the pilot, Ziva is currently working on making the whole thing completely autonomous, so you don't even need a pilot's license. And with a range of around 50 miles and a top speed of 160 miles per hour, the Zero will target emergency first responders initially, as a way to help those in need as quickly as possible. Zero emissions and zero waiting. Go anywhere, from anywhere. When a group of aerospace engineers, software developers, and tech experts come together for a single purpose, great things tend to happen. That's the hope, at least, with Paragon Aerospace and its lofty goals of tackling not only our carbon footprint, but improving the global infrastructure. So, what is their plan of attack on such formidable foes? Well, their focus is being spent on the Soar, a hydrogen-powered VTOL, or vertical takeoff and landing. The Soar is designed to carry up to 9 passengers between 300 and 400 miles, using 8 motors. Paragon is intent on perfection and has created every aspect of their ambitious project themselves, from the airframe to the motors and thermal equipment. Ultimately, the goal is to create a hub network to station a good number of these innovative birds. They seem to have their eyes on Brownsville, Texas. In 2012, a group of Toyota employees established the pro bono group Cartivator and began work on the SD00 shortly after. This was a scale model prototype of a flying car that the company had envisioned creating. They successfully ran driving and hovering tests with the prototype only 6 months later. Still, before they could work on the real deal, they needed to scale it up first. And so, the production of the SD01 had begun, and the new group, SkyDrive, would arise. SkyDrive was the new addition of Cartivator and would oversee the production of the SD series, such as the new SD01 project. Information on this new prototype is sparse, but it was a very early design with a metal frame, four wheels, two seats, a steering wheel, and four rotors. However, tests were a success, so SkyDrive was able to raise funding, shake hands, and make friends. So they leaped into making their goal a reality. Now you know the story, so let's get to the good stuff. The SD03, and the current project being developed, the SDXX. The SD03 made its first public demonstration in 2020 and featured a much more commercial design than the previous prototypes. The single-seat design resembles contemporary eVTOLs and measures around 13 feet long and 11 feet wide. Four rotors are evenly split between each corner. Each rotor is powered by its own motor as a fail-safe mechanism. A pilot flew for 4 minutes around 1 hectare of land during the demonstration, while a computer handled the flight stability and safety. At this point, SkyDrive has shaped up to be the leader of Japan's eVTOL scene, with many sponsorships, such as Bandai Namco and Mitsubishi. For a future project, Suzuki has teamed up with SkyDrive for a special project that looks like it could be the SDXX. Suzuki will handle things like business and technology research and development, and help with mass producing SkyDrive's next project. This means SkyDrive is left to focus on creating the best compact two-seater eVTOL possible. Although the SDXX is still in development, hence the placeholder name, it still boasts a much more striking image than its predecessor, the SD03. It adds another seat to the mix for two people to enjoy a ride in the glass-covered cabin. And because of its three wheels and land-driving capabilities, it technically falls into the category of a flying car rather than an eVTOL. The Seraph, by Britain's Vertical Aerospace, is testing its eVertical takeoff and landing drone, which the company hopes to sell in the emerging global air taxi market. The three-person craft has 6 arms, each with 2 rotors. In its current form, it can carry up to 551 pounds and reach a top speed of 50 miles per hour. The design is customizable in that it can be changed in size if needed, as well as having the option for wheels or floats. If you enjoyed this video, you could help us out by hitting the like button, subscribe, and keep up to date on future posts.